Good afternoon to everyone. Thank you for joining me for this important announcement in terms of education and emphasizing some of the great things this General Assembly has done during this session of the legislature in the area of education and raising teacher salaries. I'm delighted to be joined by our Secretary of Education, Johnny Key, as well as the key legislators that have supported this and caused it to happen. Representative John Eubanks, the majority leader in the House. We have Chairman Bruce Cozart, who is chairman of the House Judiciary Committee. Senator Missy Irvin will be joining us a little bit later. And there I have the Secretary Key over here. In addition, we have Superintendent Jim Tucker from El Dorado School District, as well as Ashley Curtis, a teacher from El Dorado High School. Where's Ashley? There you are, okay. And so let me first make the announcement that I'll be shortly signing a historic bill that will raise the median teacher salary in Arkansas by $2,000. It will raise the target median salary for the state to $51,822, which is $2,000 higher than the current median. And in addition, each year, each biennium, the Education Adequacy Committee can review where we are in terms of our median salary level and determine whether that should be increased again. As you know, in previous legislative sessions, we raised the minimum salary level for teachers, and this time we tackled the medium salary level, which will make a big difference for the teachers, particularly in the more rural or school districts that have not been able to raise consistently the teacher salaries in recent years. This is an effort to have competitive teacher salaries all across the state of Arkansas. And this helps us to get there. I see that we're joined by some educational leaders. Would you all just introduce yourselves because you've got the mask on? Go ahead.
I'm Michelle Lynch, Executive Director of the Arkansas State Teachers Association.
I'm Carol Fleming. I am the President of the Arkansas Education Association.
I'm Mike Mertens. I'm the Assistant Executive Director with the Arkansas Association of Education with Ministry.
Thank you for joining me today. You all are a key part of this as well, and thanks for being here for this signing. The second part, and this is historic and unique, the second part of this announcement is that the bill reduces the disparity between the highest and lowest median salaries in the state and will also provide additional state money of $25 million to help the school districts that are not up to the median salary to get there. And so this is really moving toward equalization, equitable education across Arkansas by not only requiring the median salary to be raised, but also by creating the teacher salary equalization fund that will allow $185 per student in those districts that are below that median salary. This is a real change. It is a new creative way to help teachers have a salary that is more competitive and help our smaller districts and in districts that have struggled more with teacher salary to be competitive with some of the urban areas and the other school districts in the state. This will help our state to recruit good teachers, to continue to improve education. And with that, I wanted to recognize Superintendent Jim Tucker from the El Dorado School District to talk about what it means for his school district.
So for years, we have really strived to raise the salary in the El Dorado School District. And it can be a struggle at times. But this bill, thanks to the legislators, Governor Hutchinson and Secretary Key, this coming school year will provide nearly $800,000 to our school district. With that, we will definitely be raising salaries. Actually, tonight on our board agenda, we have on our agenda for the board to vote a salary increase in anticipation of this bill. Teachers deserve to be fairly compensated. Teachers deserve more than what they get. They are the lifeline of our state, and I am very, very happy about this bill and excited for our teachers in El Rey School District. Governor, thank you very much.
We did some back-of-the-envelope testing as to what this would mean for the El Dorado School District, $185 per student. It's close to $700,000. That this will mean to help equalize their salary and to raise those. One of the beneficiaries of this salary increase will be Ashley Curtis, who is a teacher but also a coach at El Dorado School District. Ashley, could you come and talk about this?
First, I would like to say thank you to all of the legislators and Governor Hutchinson for this raise that teachers are getting. This is an awesome and amazing thing for all teachers here in our state. It is a great way to, like you said, to get teachers to not only keep great educators, but to get great educators to our schools here in Arkansas. And so with that, I wanted to say thank you.
Thank you, Ashley. Not just for the comments, but for your teaching and your devotion to the profession and to the students as well. Before I sign this bill, this is an opportunity just to underscore how important this legislative session has been for education. And sometimes that gets overshadowed. But in this session, just a few of the bills that have already been signed into law would be Act 400 that increases school transportation funding. Thank you, Representative Cozart and Senator Irvin. There is Act 622 that is really an outgrowth of our school safety commission that I created, in which school resource officers will have an MOU with local law enforcement, and that is required, and as well as training. You have the Act 620, the School Safety Act, that requires audits of school safety and also creates a school safety board in the Criminal Justice Institute. You have Act 513 that grants teaching licenses to DACA students and educators. Act 414 adds a requirement, one of my priorities, of computer science credit for graduation. And then Act 611 requires the Holocaust education to be taught in the schools. These are significant education bills, and I think the top of it all is this increase in teacher pay, which is fundamental to our future. And so before I sign that, Secretary Key, did you want to make... Oh, there's Senator Irvin. Yes, thank you, Senator Irvin. A number of these bills you sponsored, led. Thank you for your work as chairperson of the Senate Education.
Thank you, Governor. You know, legislative sessions are often a time where the focus is on, or the focus can be on, the topics that divide us. In this case, I think this is a celebration of a topic that unites all of us and unites all Arkansans. When you think about what we have done for teachers, and I give credit to the governor and his administration, to the chairs, to Representative Eubanks, because for several sessions now, they've had a focus on raising teacher salaries, raising the minimum salaries, and now raising that median salary, the average salary across the state, so that we can be competitive. And I'm very proud of the partnership that is culminating here today with these two bills, with the education groups, where we've talked a lot with them and had conversations about what we need to do, and with the legislators on how we go about getting this done. I want to thank them all. Thank all the groups, the legislators, everyone that's been involved in this process.
Before we actually do the signing, is there any question? Yes.
Thank you, Governor. Could you break down for us a little bit how this increase is funded, and does any part of it come from raising insurance premiums for public school or state employees?
No, it doesn't come totally separate from that. There's a separate fund that's created. $15 million of it will come from the adequacy funding that the legislature passed, and then another $10 million will come from the Educational Adequacy Trust Fund, And so that combines with $25 million that is set a separate pool of money to help those school districts raise their teacher salary. Yes?
And is it both the House and Senate companion bills that you're signing today?
That is correct. And I don't know whether we have anybody remotely, so I think we're good. All right, with that, let's come around, and of course, they'll be ready for questions. So I have Senate Bill 504, Senator Ervin, to create the Teacher Salary Equalization Fund, which we have just described. Great work again, and it is my honor to sign this bill today. Yeah. And could the educators come on over here behind too? That's Senate Bill 504, and then we have House Bill 1614, the companion bill, Representative Cozart, and again, Representative Eubanks, thank you for your shepherd in it as well. And this is the companion bill to raise teacher salary and to create the Salary Equalization Fund. And with that, these two laws, these two bills become law. Let's give it a round of applause. Thank you, Missy.
Thank you so much.
And let's see here. Representative Cozart.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Let's see here. John, there you go. Excellent. This is your first pen.
Yes, it is. Thank you.
And Superintendent.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for coming up here. That's great.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you, Governor.
Sorry we...
No, you're fine. I had to do the resolution.
No, appreciate your guys.
Thank you. Yeah.